Knock, knock. Who's there? The California drought that's been around for 4 freaking years and isn't going anywhere anytime soon unless we do something about it. Wait. I saw this on the news. The governor's mandating 25% cuts in water use, right? So problem solved. Nope. Not exactly. Well, that is true, the mandate really only tackles stuff that we use, like showers and toilets and crap like that. That only accounts for 20% of California's overall water use. The other 80%, the big chunk, the giant waster, where most of the water in California is going. 80%, that's 80, 8 followed by a 0, a B on a math test in college. 80% of California's water use goes into agriculture. So let's examine that for a second. Much like oil, we built this infrastructure around the idea that water was gonna last forever. But what do you know? It's not. This past January was the driest California has had on record since record keeping began in 1895. You know what else happened in 1895? Volleyball was invented. So that was a heck of a long time ago. You see, with climate change and a couple other factors, California hasn't been getting as much rain and snow as it's used to. So to compensate for the lack of surface water, people have been pulling it out of the ground. Statewide, they've been losing about 12 million acre feet of water every year since 2011. And in case you don't exist in the world of acre feet math, that's about 43,560 cubic feet, or about 6 million Olympic swimming pools. But wait, you don't live in California, so why should you care? Because all that stuff that you love to eat comes from California and their beautiful soil. California is home to a third of the veggies, 2/3 of the nuts and fruits, and 90% of all the wine cultivated in the US. So if all that dries up, no matter where you are, you're gonna feel it. So no matter where you are, we've gotta do something about it. So what can you do? Showering less, turning off the faucet when you brush your teeth, or not dumping water on your front lawn can help, but it's not gonna solve the main problem. If you remember from a minute ago when I said that 80% of California's water use went into agriculture, that there is the Goliath that we as David must slay with our metaphorical slingshots. If you're in California, and I know people say this a lot, but it's really important, contact your representatives, ask for water rationing across all sectors, domestic, commercial, and agricultural. And it's better to contact the local guys. While the US Senate and congressmen can be helpful, chances are your state and town representatives aren't going to be in the pocket of lobbyists, and they can actually make meaningful, measurable change in the infrastructure of your community. If you're wondering how to do this, I've left tons of information about finding representatives, how to contact them, and what to say in the bar down below. But what if you're not in California? Is there anything you can do? Yes. Definitely. But we've got to deconstruct California's water use a little bit more. Get this, the almond industry alone uses up 11% of the state's water use. That's more than half of domestic use. To grow a single almond takes over a gallon of water. And because that industry is booming right now, because everyone wants their almonds, it is guzzling up so much water. And then nuts aren't even the biggest problem. Like, not even close. Meat lovers, it's time to take a step back and maybe reevaluate a little bit. Beef, or rather cow, is kind of a water hog. Just 1 pound of the stuff requires 2,500 gallons of water. That's like 100 showers. And it doesn't stop with cows either. Pigs and chickens use up tons of water too. Connected to the meat industry, there are then the wasteful feed crops. 14% of the state's water use is used to grow alfalfa. Now tell me, when was the last time you ate alfalfa? Oh wait, what was that? You can't remember? Yeah, neither can I. Alfalfa is mainly used as animal feed, and for the most part, not even the US. Farmers have been growing the stuff and selling it abroad to places like China. And they don't even really make that much money from it. Alfalfa is a pretty low-value crop, but because of the convoluted water laws in California, if farmers don't grow something on their land, they lose their rights to the water. And it's not easy to sell or trade those water rights, so the farmers end up growing something that's practically useless. So if you really want to help, consider cutting back on your almond habit, or skipping the meat once or twice or every meal. And start to really think consciously about where your food is coming from and what resources go into making it. If you're political, see the notes down below about contacting a representative or getting involved in an organization that's trying to combat this drought. But most importantly, try to eat less water and resource-intensive foods, and support the farmers that you see making sustainable choices in what they grow and how they grow it. If you have any suggestions about what folks in California can do to try and combat this drought, leave a note in the comments down below. This is a pretty nuanced topic, so I wasn't able to cover everything that I wanted to talk about, so I'm gonna be hanging out downstairs in the comments, asking you guys questions, answering yours, just trying to get discussion going so we can figure out what we can do. Also, if any of y'all live in California and wanna let me know what you're seeing, what it's like to live in this drought, what people are doing, what you're doing, that would be freaking awesome. Like the video if you liked it, subscribe if you want to see more, feel free to watch any of my other stuff. You know the drill. Have a great day. Bye.